Hi, and welcome back to my workshop, or should I say my backyard. Due to the time constraints that we have with this unit, obviously only having 11 weeks, I've decided to do some experimenting and testing at home with my cam lock jig. So during the uni break, I decided to purchase this jig, which is a cam lock jig. This top section here cuts out the cams and it has all the specific holes sized and ready to be cut out. And then this section here will make the connecting pin holes, which is then used to join both the top piece of timber with the bottom piece of timber. This jig comes with everything that you see here, as well as all the different drill bits, because there's three different size drill bits you need to use. There's the one for the actual cams, there's the one for the connector pins, and then there's one for the channel that travels between the cam lock and the actual connector pin. So this jig is made for 20 mil timber, but the timber I'm using is between 19 and 18 mil timber. So that's caused a problem with how flush the actual cam locks have become on the actual timber. I experienced this last semester with my TECH306 project, which you would have seen, but I'll upload some photos with that as well. But basically the idea I spoke to Jeff about was to use some packers within this jig itself to try and pack it out a couple of mil, so that when we drill into the depth with the depth stopper, it will be the exact depth because it is packed out, and is packed out to 20 mil rather than only 18 mil or 19 mil for the timber. So to do this, all I did was grab a couple of pieces of scrap metal from the metalwork room. So this piece here is 0.8 mil thick, and this piece here is 1.2 mil thick. So I figured I'd try two different sizes. I figured the 8 mil would probably be too little, and then the 1.2 might be too much. But it turns out they were both too little to actually pack out the jig enough and make sure that the cam locks are flush. So what I did instead was place both on top. So now we're looking at a piece that is now 2 mil thick, and I use that within the jig itself. So what happens is these little side pieces here, they have a little adjustment and they just lift up like that. All I did is then place the metal within the actual jig like that, and then my timber then slotted underneath here, and then obviously I used the clamp to clamp it all down and clamp it together. I found this worked the best and the easiest as well, and it ended up turning out really, really well, which I'll show you now. So I used some scraps of my timber that I'm using to construct my module one of my desk, and with that I've created two different tests. So this first test here, as you can see, it is not flush, it is too far into the actual hole itself, so that was a no-go. And to combat that, I've decided to use the packers, and now this is a complete flush cam lock, and it's actually attached to the piece of timber as well when you try and pull it. Now the thing is, it does look a little bit unflush here on the bottom section, but that's because there is a little bit of movement with the timber itself, and until you get a second cam lock in on the other side to hold the timber in place, that's when it will come completely flush. So that's part one of my testing and experimenting with my cam lock joint.